In this video, we're constructing the plot of a polar equation known as a Rose curve. So here's our equation. And we're going to do this by just plugging in a bunch of special angle points until we get a sense for what the graph is going to do. We'll start out by doing this in quite a bit of detail, and then I'm just going to fast forward through them really quick. Otherwise, this video would be way too long. Finally, at the end, we're asked to compare to a computer algebra system plot. And actually what I did is I prepared an animation for this so you can see how the curve is swept out as theta increases. So where I'm going to start out here, because this is very useful in the long run, is to look at the angles theta corresponding to the maximum magnitude of r. So that's when r is equal to plus or minus 4. And I notice that this happens when 3 theta is equal to 0. In other words, theta is equal to 0. Because the argument of the cosine function vanishes there, and I get the cosine of 0, which is 1, multiplied by 4, and I get r equals 4. Okay, so let's plot this point real quick. R is 4, theta is 0, and I'm right here. And that's our starting point. The next angle that gives me a maximum magnitude for r is when 3 theta is equal to pi. That means theta is pi over 3. And r is going to be 4 times the cosine of pi, which is negative 4, because the cosine of pi is negative 1. So for this one, I aim at the angle pi over 3, but then I go backwards 4 steps, which puts me all the way down here. Next, when 3 theta is equal to 2 pi, again, I'll have a maximum magnitude for r. And this corresponds to an angle of theta equals 2 pi over 3. And r is going to be 4 times the cosine of 2 pi, in other words, 4. So when I aim in the direction of 2 pi over 3, I go 4 units from the origin. Now, once you get used to graphing Rose curves, this is all you really need to do before you realize what the entire shape of the curve is going to be. These actually turn out to be the tips of the petals or the leaves for the Rose curve. But since this is our first one, we're going to go into some detail on plotting point by point. So what I'm going to do is step up the value of 3 theta by pi over 4 at a time. We'll start with 3 theta equals 0. We did it already. How about 3 theta equals pi over 4? That means theta would be pi over 12. That's halfway between pi over 6 and an angle of 0. And we need to find our r value, and that's going to be 4 times the cosine of 3 theta, 4 times the cosine of pi over 4. And the cosine of pi over 4 is root 2 over 2, so I get 2 root 2. Now the square root of 2 is about 1.4, so we're talking about 2.8. So we're at this angle that's halfway between pi over 6 and 0, and I want to go a distance of about 2.8. So that's something like this. Next, we go to 3 theta equals 2 pi over 4, or pi over 2. That means we're looking at an angle of theta equals pi over 6, a familiar special angle. And my r value is going to be 4 times the cosine of 3 theta, which is pi over 2. Well, the cosine of pi over 2 vanishes, so r is equal to 0 by the time I get here. So the way this curve is starting to trace is something like this. As theta increases, it's being drawn in that direction. And actually, what I have here is the first half of the first petal. Okay, I'm going to proceed like this until I have similar points for the entire curve. It's a lot of calculation, so we're just going to press the fast forward button. If there's anything you want to double check, just pause the video and look at it closer. And finally, we have 3 theta equals 12 pi over 4. In other words, theta equals pi. And I end up with r equals negative 4. So we aim straight to the left, and then we go backwards 4 steps. That gets me back to the starting point for the curve, and I'm done. So this is probably the last time I'll do that many points in one video, but it's nice to see once how it works. Let's bring in the animation of this thing and check it out. And the cool thing about this animation is that it really communicates that flow when theta increases of how this curve is being traced. And one thing I want to point out here is that the entire curve was traced as theta went from 0 to pi. So that's why you see it just tracing itself a second time before the animation resets. The other key point to take away from this is that a Rose curve with an odd coefficient of theta that coefficient tells you how many petals it's going to have. So this one had a 3 in there, and it has 3 petals. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.